Welcome, welcome. Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome, welcome tonight, welcome. Well. God is good. God is good. God is really, really good tonight. We'd like to say a big welcome to each and every one of you. We're always excited to be here. I was glad when they said unto me, "Let us go into the house of the Lord," even when the house of the Lord is online. As long as it is the house of the Lord, I'm always happy. I'm always excited to be in the house of the Lord. We'd like to say a big welcome back to this prayer line as we keep on battling coronavirus. Welcome all our pastors, all our elders, all our deacons, all our deaconesses, all our church workers, everywhere. Welcome all pastors and ministers from other churches that join us today. And all our friends on our podcast from various parts of the world, we thank you for joining us on the broadcast of today. Believe it or not, you did it. You did it. We now have over 1,000 downloads on our podcast. 1,000. in less than 3 weeks. We give God the glory for that. Keep on listening. Keep on downloading. Keep on getting blessed. All our friends from Trinidad, our friends from Jamaica, our friends from Guyana, from Canada, and from all over the United States, we'd like to say a big welcome to you to this program for tonight. Before we go any further, let's ask the Father to bless us and give us the grace to do everything in His own plan and His own will for us tonight in the name of Jesus. Holy Father, how we thank You. You said where two or three are gathered together in Your name. You didn't say where they would be, but You said You are in the midst of them. We're scattered all over the world, but You are in our midst. You join us together, and we bless You for that. We want to pray again using the priestly prayer to call on You. We ask You, Lord God, that the anointing that was on that prayer in the book of Numbers will be upon this program tonight in the name of Jesus. Bless us in a very, very special way. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen and amen and amen. Yesterday, I began looking with you into the prayer that God commanded Moses to command the priest to pray for all the Israelites that gathered together for worship. And he said, when My people gather together for worship, this is how I want You to bless them. So there is divine approval on this prayer that we are using to pray tonight. And in Numbers chapter 6 in verse 24, he says, when you pray, say this. Number one, say the Lord bless thee. Say the Lord keep thee. Say the Lord make His face to shine upon thee, and the Lord be gracious unto thee. Tell them the Lord lift up His countenance upon thee, and tell them that the Lord give you peace. And when you do that, you can turn them loose and let them go home. And yesterday we began with the first of these series of prayers, the blessings of the Lord. And I tell you what, I felt the anointing of God upon this program yesterday. I felt the blessing of the Lord come down upon His people yesterday. Don't take lightly the need to bless people. Bless your husband, bless your wife, bless your children, bless your household, bless your automobile, bless your business, bless everything that is around you. It's a commandment. I think I preached a message on that before. Maybe if I can find where it is, I'll put it on the podcast. The need to bless people. And God did that for us yesterday. I thought that we were going to be able to go to the second part, which is the Lord keep thee. But we didn't have the time. We ran out of time receiving the blessings of God yesterday. So what I'm going to do today is start with the Lord keep thee. Oh, do we need to be kept at this time? It's God who has been keeping us, kept by the power of God, kept by the mercy of God, kept by the grace of God, kept by the kindness of God. So we want to call on God, first of all tonight, that keeping grace, that keeping mercy will not depart from us all the days of our lives. But if we have the time, and I believe we will, we also want to pray verse 25 and part of verse 26. It says, and the Lord make His face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee and lift up His countenance upon thee and give you peace. But for tonight, we'll take the keeping part. We'll take the His face shining upon you part. We'll take the Lord being gracious unto you part. And then we'll see how far we're able to go. I pray that grace will be granted unto you. Grace will be granted unto me to be able to pray tonight, that we will not be tired, we will not be weary. And that those who are coming behind to join us, God will give them speed to dial in and join us on this prayer line, or to go online and join our podcast. The Lord will bless you because everything is live. I pray, Lord God, that you will have your way in this prayer line tonight. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name, I pray. Amen and amen. Let's begin by giving God thanks. Let's begin by giving God praise. Let's begin by giving God glory. Let's begin by giving him honor. Let's begin by giving him dominion. Let's begin by giving him adoration. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we adore you for bringing us to this place again today. People, let's praise him. Let's praise him for making it possible for us to assemble again in our different states, in our different nations, in our different locations, to be together, to pray with one heart, to pray with one spirit. I want us to thank God for how he's been with us since we started these prayers a couple of weeks ago. I want you to thank God for how he has blessed you. I want you to thank God for those who have been touched. I want you to thank God for those who are supposed to have been destroyed, but God used this prayer to save them from destruction. Father, we praise you, we bless you, we worship you, we adore you, we honor you, we glorify your holy name. Thank you, Lord, for not leaving us alone. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for standing with us. Glory be to your name. Honor be to your name. I was here yesterday. You are here yesterday. And here you are. You are still here today. It's the mercy of God. For that we give God the praise. For that we give God the glory. For that we give God the honor. For that we give God the dominion. Hallelujah. Father, we bless you. Father, we worship you. Father, we thank you. I wanted to thank God for his protection upon your life. God has kept you. God has watched over you. God has protected you all these weeks, all these months, and if I may say all these years. Father, we bless you. We cannot keep ourselves. We cannot protect ourselves. We cannot watch over ourselves, even if we wanted to do it. Father, while we slept, you kept us. While we were awake, you kept us. Father, we bless you. We thank you. We glorify you for your hand that is upon our lives in the name of Jesus. I want you to thank God that you are not tired of this prayer. Hallelujah. I thank God that I'm not tired of leading this prayer. Hallelujah. Do you know it's not by might? Do you know it's not by power? It's by his spirit. That's what the word of God says. So Father, we give you praise for everything we've been able to do. It's not by might. It's not by power. It's by your spirit. Glory to God. Father, we thank you. Father, we praise you. Father, we worship you. Father, we adore you. Thank you, Lord, for keeping us through many dangers, through many traps, through many snares. Hallelujah. Give God a thanks for his keeping grace, for his keeping power. We are beginning with keeping tonight. So let's just thank him for how he has kept us in the past from many, 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 many troubles, from many, 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 many dangers, from many, many, many traps, from many, many, many snares. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him for his angels that you don't see, but I see you. They watch over you day and night. Hallelujah. They go with you when you go out. They come in with you when you come in. Accidents that you will have had, the angels prevented it. Attacks that will have come upon you, the angels prevented them. Come on, give him praise. Give him glory. Give him honor. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him for this mighty, 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 mighty watchers that watch over us, and we don't have to pay God. There's no bill that God sends to us at any time. Lord, we thank you for protection from all attacks that are seen. We thank you for protection from all attacks that are not seen. Glory be to his name. Thank God for keeping you from the terrors of the night and from the pestilence that walketh in darkness. Give him glory. Give him glory for his keeping power tonight. Before we ask him to keep us more, let's thank him for what he's already done. Hallelujah. Lord, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for keeping us from the terrors of the night. Thank you for keeping us from the pestilence that walketh in darkness. Thank you for keeping us when we were about to be slain by terrible dreams. You watched over us. You made us wake up again. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Father, we bless you. Father, we worship you. Father, we adore you. Father, we honor you. Glory to God. Glory to God. We give you praise. Let's praise him. For our eyes have seen many evils. Our ears have heard of many bad news. But we have not experienced them. For that we should give him praise. Don't you think? Our eyes have seen many, many, many evils. Our ears have heard many, many bad news. But God has not allowed us to experience any one of them. For that we give him glory. For that we give him praise. For that we give him honor. For that we give him dominion. For that we give him adoration tonight. Lord, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. Because you said in your word that with our eyes we shall see, but it shall not come near our dwelling. Oh God, we glorify you for that. We bless you and we worship you for that. Father, accept our thanks. I want you to thank God for the opportunity he has given you to pray this part of the priestly prayer tonight. We are going to pray that God will keep us. We are going to pray that God will lift up his countenance upon us. We are going to pray that God will be gracious unto us tonight. I want you to thank God for the opportunity to pray that prayer in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray if there be anything in your heart, if there be anything in your life, there be anything that will hinder your prayers from being answered tonight, God will come down and wash you and cleanse you and purge you and purify you in the name of Jesus Christ, that your prayer will not be returned to sender. Your prayer will not be returned unanswered, but God will show mercy in answering your prayer and in giving you the desires of your heart tonight. Father, we pray that you will wash us tonight. You will cleanse us tonight, because the Bible says, if I behold and if I have and if I harbor iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. Not just that the Lord will not answer me, but that the Lord will not hear me. Father, I pray that if there be any iniquity in my heart tonight, if there be any sin in my heart tonight, sin of omission or sin of commission, I want the Lord to wash me, to cleanse me, to purge me. I want the Lord to remove everything that will hinder me, all unbelief, all doubt, all double-mindedness, that I'll be able to focus on prayers tonight and be able to hear God say, well done and well prayed in the name of Jesus. I want you to ask the Lord, every barrier, every blockage, every hindrance in your way, the Lord will take them out of your way tonight in the name of Jesus. Or will push them out of your life tonight in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray for the spirit of prayer. Pray for the spirit of supplication. Tell the Lord, let the spirit of prayer envelope me right now. Let the spirit of supplication envelope me right now. Remove all weariness from me, O God. Remove all tiredness from me, O God. Let the spirit of intercession fall on me mightily in the name of Jesus. So that the 1.5 hours we are going to spend will look like half an hour in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Spirit of prayer, envelope us in the name of Jesus. Spirit of prayer, come upon us tonight and help us to be able to intercede in the name of Jesus. Let there be no hindrance, let there be no distraction, even as we pray for your keeping power as we begin praying tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, have your way here tonight. Father, bless us tonight as we pray, O God. Father, renew our strength as we pray, O God. You said, they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. Father, our expectation tonight is that the prayer of tonight will lead to the renewal of our strength in you, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I pray that the anointing of the priest will come upon each and every one of us as we pray tonight. Father, let the anointing of the priest come upon us, because us who we are in real fact. We are priests according to the word of God. I want the anointing of the priest to come upon me. I want the anointing of the priest to come upon you, that we pray the prayer that only priests can pray tonight. Hallelujah. We'll pray it by faith. We'll pray it with understanding. We'll pray it knowing that we are praying the scriptures. And God can never deny us because we are praying his word. Have your way, O God. Have your way, O God. Have your way among us tonight, O God, in the name of Jesus. Give strength to us, O God, especially those that is past midnight, their time right now. I pray that you will keep them alert, you will keep them awake, even as we pray tonight, and you will reward them for this sacrifice of staying up this late. You will reward them for spending money on their phone to be able to log in to hear this tonight. Father, let there be the reward for those selfless sacrifices. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that you tell the Lord, say, my Father, my Father. I want you to say after me, say, my Father, my Father. Say it again. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, as I go through these dangerous days, as I go through these dangerous days, I hand over the keeping of my life into your able hands. Father, as I go through these dangerous days, I hand over the keeping of my life into your able hands. Keep on keeping me, O God. Open your mouth and pray that prayer in the name of Jesus, that the one who has been keeping you, who never slumbers, the one who has been keeping you, who never sleeps, as you go through these very, very dangerous days, we hand over our life into his hand, that he will continue to keep us. He will continue to keep us in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. That's how the priest prayed. And we prayed the Lord bless you yesterday. And today we are praying the Lord keep you in the name of Jesus. Father, keep us through these dangerous times. Keep us through these dangerous days. Let no evil, let no harm befall us, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. We decree that no evil, no danger will touch us. Keep us by your feathers. Keep us by your eyes. Keep watching over us. Keep protecting us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to open your mouth and tell the Lord to keep on keeping you. I want you to tell the Lord to keep on watching over you. I want you to tell the Lord to keep on protecting you through these very, very dangerous times. Tell the Lord, as I go through these dangerous days, maybe you walk in the hospital. Those are dangerous places. Maybe you walk in a place where you are so close together. Those are dangerous places. I want you to hand over the keeping of your life into his able hands. Say, Father, I hand over my life to you in the name of Jesus. I'm not handing over my life to coronavirus. I'm handing over my life to you, O God. Whatever is handed over to you to keep it safe, all right? In the name of Jesus, keep me safe. In the name of Jesus, keep me protected. In the name of Jesus, as I hand over the protection of my life into your hand, Father, keep me safe, keep me protected all the time. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Lord, keep on watching over me. Lord, keep on protecting me. I want you to pray for your children. I want you to pray for your wife. I want you to pray for your husband. I want you to pray for your spouse. I want you to pray for your grandmother. I want you to pray for your grandfather. Father, keep them under the surveillance of God. Keep them and watch over them. Let no evil befall them. Let no harm come to them, O God. I bring them under the keeping power of God. Father, you have the power to keep. You are the keeper, O God. And he that keeps Israel, he that keeps Zion, he that keeps his people, he never slumbers, he never sleeps. Father, you've kept me so far. Keep on keeping me, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, kept by the power of God. I want you to tell the Lord you have no other keeper in the name of Jesus. God knows that already, but I want you to tell him tonight. Some people trust in chariots. Some people trust in horses, but we only remember the name of the Lord our God. He's the one that keeps us day in, day out. He's the one that watches over us in the name of Jesus. Say, Father, I'm in your hand. Hallelujah. Say, Father, I'm in your hand. Oh, in the name of Jesus. And I know I'm safe in your hands. Keep on watching over me. Keep on protecting me, oh God. Keep on protecting my children, oh God. I want us to pray for our children at this juncture. You know, our children don't pray because they cannot pray. What do you expect a 1-year-old to pray? What do you expect a 5-year-old to pray? I want you to pray for them. Pray for them tonight. Father, I pray that as you keep me, you keep my children, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, that we will not suffer the loss of any of our children to this pandemic, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, watch over us. Father, keep us. Father, protect us. I pray for these children, oh God. Keep them, keep them, keep them, keep them. Let none of them succumb to this virus, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Watch over them, Holy Father. Father. Watch over them day in, day out. Watch over them everywhere they go. Watch over them everywhere they play. Watch over them everywhere they sit. Watch over them everywhere they stand. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. As we go through dangerous times, oh Lord, we hand over the keeping of our lives into your holy hands. We hand over the keeping of our lives into your able hands. Watch over us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I want you to make a decree as we go on tonight. Say, God will so keep me. Come on, open your mouth and say it. Say, God will so keep me. Say it one more time. Say, God will so keep me. Say it one more time. Say, God will so keep me. My health will not become a shipwreck in 2020. In the name of Jesus, I decree that God will keep me and will not allow my health to become a shipwreck in 2020. In the name of Jesus. Come on, open your mouth in the name of Jesus. Father God, keep me, keep my health. Father, keep me healthy, O God, in such a way, O God, that my health will not fall into trouble. My health will not fall into disaster in 2020, in the name of Jesus. Keep my body. Keep my body. Keep my health, oh God. Keep me healthy in 2020. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. My father used to say to us when we were young that it is only those that God protects that are safe from danger. I want you to pray that God will continue to keep your health from danger of coronavirus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Tell the Lord to keep you from stumbling and falling into the trap of coronavirus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, it's a conspiracy against your health. It's a conspiracy against my health, but it shall not prosper. In the name of Jesus, we reject it. It shall not prosper. It will not prosper. It must not prosper. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, tell the Lord, keep me from stumbling. Keep me from falling into the trap of coronavirus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, oh God, guide my path, oh God. Keep my steps, O God, from the den of coronavirus infection. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Those of you who walk in the hospital, you need to pray that prayer. Those of you who go to groceries, you need to pray that prayer. Those of you who go to the post office, you need to pray that prayer. Those of you who go into the buses, you need to pray that prayer. Those of you who go on the train, you need to pray that prayer. Those of you who go in the taxi, you need to pray that prayer. Those of you who ride on the motorcycle, you need to pray that prayer. You don't know who is riding the motorbike. I want you to pray that you will not stumble into any trap of coronavirus. When it becomes 1 foot for you to get into coronavirus, the Lord will guide your steps and keep your steps from virus infection. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, you are the keeper. We want you to keep us. We want you to guide us from where infection is. We want you to keep us. We want you to guide us from where trouble is, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Come on, open your mouth and talk to the Lord tonight, that the hedge of protection will be around you every second, every minute, every hour in these dangerous times, that the hedge of protection of God will be around your life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. You meet people, you don't know what is on them. You meet people, you don't know what is in them. I want you to pray protection. That is what it means by the Lord will bless you and the Lord will keep you. That the Lord will keep you means the Lord will protect you. I want you to pray that the edge of protection shall be around your life every second of these dangerous times. The edge of protection will be around you every minute of these dangerous times. The edge of protection will be upon you every hour of these dangerous times. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, hedge me around. Father, hedge my family around. Come on, pray for your family tonight. Lord, hedge us around, O God, and keep us from every evil in the name of Jesus. Oh God, surround us with a hedge of protection day in, day out. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I want you to decree tonight that the Lord will keep you from the list of casualties of coronavirus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, that the Lord will keep you from the list of casualties of coronavirus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, keep me, keep me, keep me, keep me, keep me, keep me. Keep me, oh God, 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 in the name of Jesus, from anything and everything. Keep me and mine, oh God, from becoming casualties of coronavirus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I wanted to talk to the Lord tonight. Yes, 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 yes. Oh Lord, keep us. Oh Lord, keep your people. Oh Lord, keep your people. Tell the Lord to build a wall of life, a wall around your life that no coronavirus will be able to penetrate. In the name of Jesus, Father, build a wall of protection around us. Tell the Lord to build it and build it tonight. In the name of Jesus, we will continue to pray until this thing is over. Even if it looks as if we are repeating ourselves, it's okay, it's okay. There's nothing wrong in repeating yourself. After all, Jesus Christ prayed three times the same prayer, first time, the same prayer, second time, the same prayer, third time. And some people say they have so much faith, it is wrong to pray one prayer three times. Come on, that is persistence. We are persistently praying until this evil is over, until this tempest is over. So don't let anything shake your faith. Open your mouth. If you prayed it yesterday, pray it today. If you pray it today, pray it tomorrow, until this thing is over. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let's tell the Lord to build a wall of protection around us tonight. Father, build a wall of protection around me and my family in the name of Jesus. I came to remind you again, Lord. I came to put you in remembrance again, Lord. Let a wall of protection surround my entire family, a wall that no coronavirus can penetrate. In the name of Jesus, I pray it for me. I pray for my household. I pray for my extended family. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. God forbid that you will be going from hospital to hospital, visiting your friends, visiting your neighbors, visiting the people that are connected to you. And they say, why are you here? You say, because somebody has the virus and is being incubated. That shall not be your portion. In the name of Jesus, it shall not be your portion. In the name of Jesus, it shall not be my portion. I want you to pray tonight over yourself and over your household that the Lord will build a wall in the name of Jesus, a wall that cannot be penetrated by coronavirus. Father, build your protection around us. Let your keeping power be upon us. Let your keeping grace be upon us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Your wall of protection. Okay, you see, all right, I have a wall of protection already. I don't want to pray it. Okay, I want you to pray this prayer that the wall of protection around me will not come down like the walls of Jericho. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, the wall that you have built, let it never come down like the walls of Jericho. Because the walls of Jericho were built strong. They were built powerfully. They were built high, and yet they came down. My Father, my Father, my Father, tonight, the walls around me will not crumble like the walls of Jericho in the name of Jesus. Don't allow the walls of your protection over my life. Don't allow them to come down like the walls of Jericho tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Pray the same prayer over your wife. Pray the same prayer over your husband. Pray the same prayer over your children, your grandchildren, your grandparents, that the Lord will watch over them, that the Lord will keep them. That the walls that God has built around them, the wall of protection, nothing will break it. Nothing will break them in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray, 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 that throughout this pandemic period, God will keep you and your entire household under his feathers of protection. In the name of Jesus, Psalm 91 tells us that. Say, my Father, keep me and my entire household under your feathers of protection. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let us be under your feathers of protection all through this period, O God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, let us hide. Let us hide my entire household. Hide us under your feathers of protection, keeping us in the process thereby. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I want you to decree tonight that no matter how many fall around you, in the name of Jesus, no matter how many people fall around you, that everyone connected to you will be kept strong and they will be kept healthy in the name of Jesus. Father, no matter how many people are affected, no matter how many people are infected, those that are connected to me, O God, let them be kept strong, let them be kept healthy, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Keep me, keep the people around me strong, keep the people around me healthy, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, keep us strong, Father, keep us healthy, Father, keep us strong, Father, keep us healthy. Can I ask you to pray that prayer for a minute? The reason you don't have virus right now is because God has protected you. I want you to pray that prayer, that the Lord will keep you strong, that the Lord will keep you healthy, that the Lord will keep you strong, that the Lord will keep you healthy. Oh God, keep my children strong, keep my children healthy. Oh God, keep the people that are connected to me strong, keep the people that are connected to me healthy, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, keep us strong, oh Lord, keep us healthy, in the name of Jesus. Pray for your father, pray for your mother, pray for your in-laws, in the name of Jesus, that no matter how many people fall around them, in the name of Jesus, whichever country they may be, whichever state they may be, whichever city they may be, everyone connected to us will be kept strong, everyone connected to us will be kept healthy, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Come on, open your mouth and talk to the Lord tonight. Come on, open your mouth and talk to the Lord tonight. If you have ever seen anybody, if you have ever seen anybody infected by this virus, you will pray these prayers. You will not need anybody to beg you to pray these prayers. If you have ever seen anybody infected by coronavirus, you will understand what I'm talking about. You'll understand why we are praying these prayers. I want you to pray in the name of Jesus. No matter how many fall around me, O God, let everyone connected to me be kept strong, kept healthy, kept strong, kept healthy, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Keep us strong, Holy Father. Keep us healthy, Holy Father. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' mighty, mighty, mighty name we pray. Amen. 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 I'm happy to hear your amen like you are saying it. It makes me happy. It makes me know I'm not talking to the air at all, that I have saints of God that are joining together with me in this prayer. Now, I want us to pray this prayer. I just came up with this today. I want you to say, Father, say, Father, say in the name of Jesus, let my divine health insurance policy, let my divine health insurance policy be forever kept up to date. Let it not expire, especially during this period. Say, my father, my divine health insurance policy, let it be kept up to date. Let the premiums be paid up to date. Let it not expire. Fire prayer. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, I'm operating under divine health insurance policy. Father, don't let it expire. Don't let me tamper with it. Don't let me lose my insurance. Did you hear what I said? Tell the Lord tonight, don't let me lose this valuable insurance. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Your life is insured in Christ Jesus. I want you to pray that this insurance will be kept up to date. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. You will not put your hand into anything that will cause your insurance to lapse. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. You know something about insurance? Once it lapses, it lapses. I want you to pray tonight, my Father, Father, my Father, my divine health insurance policy, let it be forever kept up to date by your power. Let it be forever kept to date by your power. Let it be forever kept to date by your mercy. Let it be forever kept to date by your grace. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I want you to pray the same prayer for those in your household, that their divine health insurance policy will forever be kept up to date, will not expire in their hands. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. I want you to say from now on, oh God, let your angels encamp round about me and my household to keep us day in, day out. In the name of Jesus. Father, let your angels encamp round about me and my whole household, day in, day out, I pray, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to decree that the angels of God will be on assignment. Yes, the angels of God will be on assignment concerning you day in, day out. In the name of Jesus, watching over you. In the name of Jesus, protecting you. In the name of Jesus, keeping you day by day. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Finally, I want you to pray that God will continue to keep you in the name of Jesus. Father, please continue to keep me. Oh, continue to keep me, continue to keep me, continue to keep me. I cannot keep myself even if I wanted to. I cannot keep myself for 1 second. I cannot keep myself for 1 minute. I can only be kept by you. I can only be kept by your power. Father, keep on keeping me in the name of Jesus. Father, keep on keeping me in the name of Jesus. Father, keep on keeping me in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, let's go to the one that says that his face will be upon you. I want you to pray tonight. Say, my Father, let your face be always upon me day and night. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord let his face be upon you and his countenance be upon you. Say, Lord, face me every day, O God. Let your face never be hidden from me, O God. Let your face never be turned away from me, O God. Let your face never be against me, O God. Did you hear those three prayer points? Maybe I should repeat them. Let your face never be hidden from me. Let your face never be turned away from me. Let your face never be turned against me. Three important prayers. Can I repeat them? I want you to pray them. O God, let your face never be hidden from me. Let your face never be turned away from me. Let your face never be turned against me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, we plead with you tonight. We plead you with you tonight. We can never survive it. We can never make it. Oh God, let your face never be hidden from us. Let your face never be turned away from us. Let your face never be turned against us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. You want to pray that prayer again, people, that his face will never be hidden from you in the name of Jesus, that his face will never be turned away from you in the name of Jesus, that his face will never be turned against you in the name of Jesus. You need this for your protection. You need this for your protection. I said you need this for your protection. That's why he told him to pray that his face will always shine upon them. I wanted to tell the Lord, let your face never be hidden from me, O God. Let your face never be turned away from me, O God. Let your face never be turned against me, O God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. How can I make it if your face is hidden from me? Where will I go if your face is hidden from me? Where will I be if your face is turned away from me? Then coronavirus or any evil whatsoever will do whatever they want to do, O God. Let your face never be turned against me, O God. Because when your face is turned against me, then anything can work against me. Father, do these three things for us right now. Even as we start this session of prayer, I want you to open your mouth and tell the Lord, let your face never be hidden from me. Let your face never be turned from me. Let your face never be turned against me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that the face of God will shine brightly upon you this year. in the name of Jesus. Father, let your face shine upon me brightly in 2020. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let your face shine brightly upon me, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, shine on me, O God. Father, shine on me, O God. Day in, day out, shine on me, O God. Everywhere I go, shine on me, O God. Let your face shine upon me, O God. O Lord, I want you to bless me. O Lord, I want you to keep me, but I want your face to shine upon me also. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord tonight. You need the face of the Lord to shine brightly upon you. In the name of Jesus, I mean every day, every day, every day, all through the year, that the face of God will shine upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to pray that the brightness of that light will drive darkness away from inside you, will drive darkness away from outside you. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, let the brightness of your light tonight, Father, so shine. Let the brightness of your light drive away darkness from inside my life and around my life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Father, let the brightness of your light shine so bright and drive away darkness from inside and drive away darkness from outside. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Come on, open your mouth and pray that prayer tonight. He said, his face will shine upon you. Father, let your face shine upon me. Let your light shine upon me. Let me see your honor. Let me see your glory. I want you to pray tonight that as the pillar of fire gave light to Israel in the wilderness, the light of God will show you the way all through the rest of your life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the pillar of fire. The pillar of fire, the pillar of fire. It gave light to the children of Israel in the wilderness. We are in another wilderness, people. I want you to pray that his light will show you the way for the rest of your life. In the name of Jesus, and shine on my path. Oh God, shine on my path. Oh God, shine on my path. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, shine on my path, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want us to pray for favor tonight, because actually when he says the light of God shines on you, it means the favor of God and the favor of man shines on you. That's what it means, actually. So I want you to pray tonight. Lord, let me begin to have great favor with God. Let me begin to have great favor with man. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, let me begin to have great favor. Favor with man. Favor with God. In the name of Jesus. When the light of God shines upon you, then you are a man of favor. Then you are a woman of favor. And you have favor with God, and you also have favor with man. Say, my Father, my Father, my Father, in the name of Jesus. Let me begin to have great favor with you, O God. Let me begin to have great favor with people around me, O God. On my job, let me find favor. In my church, let me find favor. Everywhere I turn, let me find favor. In the name of Jesus, shine on me, O Lord, with the light of favor in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray that from now on, everyone that looks upon you will be compelled to favor you. Did you hear what I said? Say, my Father, my Father. Say, from now on, let everyone that looks upon me be compelled to favor me in the name of Jesus. Put something on my face. Put something on my eyes. Put something on my face that whoever looks at me will have no choice but favor me, O God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, put your anointing upon my face. Put your anointing upon my eyes, that from tonight on, all that look upon me will be compelled. Did you hear what I said? They will be compelled. Did you hear what I said? All that look upon me from now on, they will be compelled to favor me, O God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. When he says the Lord will look upon you, I pray that it will be his favor looking upon me. I want you to pray tonight. Let there be anointing that comes upon me right now, that all the people that look upon me on my job will favor me. Those that like me will favor me. Those that hate me will favor me. From now on, O God, let all that look upon me be compelled, be forced, be made made to favor me, whether they like it or not. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I want you to decree tonight that everyone will be compelled to favor you. You remember the woman in the Word of God. You remember the woman in the Bible. That everyone that looked upon her, favored her. Just looking at her like this, it's like she put voodoo on herself, which doesn't work anyway. But God can put it on you, where everyone who looks at you say, I don't even know why, oh, but I want to favor you. I don't know why, oh, I'm not supposed to do this for you, but I will do it for you. I wanted to decree tonight that the grace of God will be so strong, the favor of God will be so strong, that everyone that looks upon you, whether they like it or not, they will be compelled to favor you in the name of Jesus. Can we pray another prayer? Hey, can we pray another prayer that those who are favoring you right now, they will not turn against you? Open your mouth and pray. Many times favor will dry up. Did you hear what I said? Many times favor will dry up. Those who used to be your friend will just turn around. They may not become your enemy, but they may not favor you anymore. I want you to pray for everlasting favor, continuous favor. Let it be my portion in the name of Jesus. He said God will look upon you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord's countenance look upon you. I want you to decree tonight, oh Lord my God, oh Lord my God, favor that is consistent on my job, with my bosses, with those that work with me, with my equals, and those that are junior to me. Favor everywhere, favor all around. If you are supervised by a trustee board, if you are supervised by some men and some women in the headquarters, that they will always favor you, that the favor you have right now, I don't know why we are praying this prayer, in the name of Jesus. Maybe somebody's favor is about to run out. I want you to pray tonight. The favor that I've taken for granted. Because after we get favor for a while, we think it's our right. I want you to say, Lord, you are the one that made these people to favor me. Oh, don't let the favor run out. 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 In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Many times we think that favor is our right. Many times we think that favor is our right. I want you to pray tonight. Lord, it's your grace, oh God. Let the favor that I'm enjoying from you, let the favor that I'm enjoying from my boss, let the favor that I'm enjoying from those that are over me, let the favor not run out. Let the favor not dry out. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that from henceforth, God's favor, God's mercy, God's goodness will bring blessings into your life. Deserved blessings, undeserved blessings. Did you hear what Bishop said? That the favor of God will bring blessings that you deserve and blessings that you don't deserve into your life. God, set me up for blessings because of your favor. Set me up for blessing. Compel bad people to do good to me in the name of Jesus. I love that one. Compel bad people. Hey, hey, hey. Everybody knows these people to be bad, but they are just compelled to do good to you. I want you to decree, and it shall be established that merciless people will show you mercy, that bad people will be good to you. Merciless people will show me mercy. Bad people will be good to me in the mighty name of Jesus. People will favor me without a reason. People will favor me without a cause. And they will say, I don't know why I'm doing this for you, but I just feel I need to do it. There's no reason for it, but they are compelled to do it. Father, begin to cause people, as you shine on us tonight, you will cause people to favor us without a cause. You will compel even bad people, people that are known to be bad, they will favor us in the name of Jesus. People that are known to be merciless, they will show us mercy. People that are known to show no kindness to anybody, they will single you out and they will show you kindness. Father, let it be because you are shining upon us. Shine all these things upon us, oh God. I want you to pray tonight that good things that you don't even ask for, the favor of God will bring them to you in the name of Jesus. Father, good things, great things, mighty things that I don't even ask for. Let your favor bring them to me. Let your mercy bring them to me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Is the countenance of God that does this thing, folks. Is the countenance of God that does this thing, folks. I want you to pray tonight. Merciless people will show you mercy. Bad people will show you goodness. Kindless people will show you kindness. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, things that you don't even ask, the favor of God will begin to give it to you. That's what it means for God to shine upon you. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, shine on me. Oh Lord, look on me. Oh Lord, shine on me. Oh Lord, look on me. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Good things that I don't even ask for. Let your favor begin to give them to me in the name of Jesus. I want you to decree tonight about the countenance of God. Hallelujah. I want us to decree about the countenance of God that it will drive away this virus far from your environment. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father God, let your glow, the glow of your countenance, oh God, let the glow of your countenance, oh God, drive away the coronavirus from my environment. In the name of Jesus. Until this thing is over, people, we cannot stop praying. Until this thing is over, we cannot stop calling on God. But we can pray that the glow of his countenance, the fire of his countenance, will drive this virus from your environment. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Wherever God has given me as my space, wherever God has given me as my space, let fire surround it. Let the fire of the glory of the countenance of God shine upon wherever I am, wherever I go, whoever I meet, and drive away coronavirus from anywhere that is called my environment. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, this wicked pandemic, let your countenance drive it away from my household. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the power of this countenance of God, the power of the countenance of God, one of these days we shall see him. One of these days we shall behold him. One of these days we shall see him face to face. But ladies and gentlemen, until we do it, let us do it by faith. Until we see him, let us do it by faith. That God shine upon me. God shine upon me. God shine upon me in the morning. God shine upon me in the afternoon. God shine upon me in the evening. And let the shining of your countenance drive away every virus in the name of Jesus. Let the mercy of your countenance prevent any virus from affecting me and anyone that is connected to me, O God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, let your goodness, let your mercy, let your favor follow me everywhere I go during this pandemic, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Favor of God, goodness of God, mercy of God, follow me everywhere I go, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Come on, begin to thank God for answering your prayer tonight. Come on, begin to give him praise, begin to give him glory, begin to give him honor. Before we go, to the Lord be gracious unto you. That's my favorite tonight. The Lord be gracious unto you. Oh, who doesn't need the grace of God? Father, we thank you for how far you have led us. We thank you for how far you have directed us. We thank you for how far you have helped us tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I wanted to decree tonight as we go to the last part of our prayer. Say, oh Lord, be gracious unto me. Oh Lord, be gracious unto me. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray tonight. I said, open your mouth and pray tonight that the Almighty God will be gracious unto you in every area of your life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, be gracious unto me, O God, in every area of my life, I pray, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, be gracious unto me, O God. Come on, pray for grace tonight. Pray for grace tonight. I love this priestly prayer. It would have not been complete if God did not say, you need my grace. I wanted to say, Lord, I need your grace. Lord, I need your grace. Jesus. I need your grace. I need your grace. I need your grace. Lord, be gracious unto me. Be gracious unto me. Father, be gracious unto me. In the name of Jesus, Father, be gracious unto me, O God. Father, be gracious unto me, O God. Father, be gracious unto me, O God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Papa, be gracious unto me. Just pray that prayer alone for a minute. Did you hear what I said? Let's pray that prayer alone for a minute. God, be gracious unto me. Lord, be gracious unto me. Lord, be gracious unto me. In the name of Jesus, I need your grace in my life, oh God. Father, show me your grace. Father, be gracious unto me, I pray. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, talk to God tonight. Talk to God tonight that the Lord will be gracious. Lord, just be gracious unto me, oh God. Father, please be gracious unto me tonight. Father, please be gracious unto me tonight. Father, I need your grace in my life, oh God. Father, I need your grace in my life, oh God. Be gracious, be gracious, be gracious unto me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, be gracious unto us. Father, be gracious unto us. In the name of Jesus, be gracious unto us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let there be so much grace from you. Let, oh Lord, pump grace into my life. Father, pump your grace into my life. That is what they call unmerited favor. Father, pump your grace into my life. Father, pump your grace into my life. Pump me full with the grace of God. Pump me full with the grace of God. Let the grace of God be upon me on my job. Let the grace of God be upon me in my home. Let the grace of God be upon my marriage. Let the grace of God be upon my relationships. Let the grace of God be upon every part of my body. Grace, 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 amazing grace. The priest will stand before the people and he will say, the Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord be gracious unto you. Father, I'm standing in the need of prayer tonight. I wish I can kneel down, but how will I get up if I kneel down now with this microphone in my hand? So I have to stand and I have to tell you, Lord, I want grace in my life. Father, please be gracious unto me. Give me unmerited favor in my life, because that's exactly what grace is. Say, Papa, be gracious. Papa, be gracious. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, show me grace. We have run out of grace. Father, show me grace where my grace has been depleted. In the name of Jesus, I want you to open your mouth. Grace to pray. In the name of Jesus, give it to me. Grace to pray. In the name of Jesus, give it to me. Grace to talk to those that you have vowed you will never talk to again. Let the Lord give it to you tonight. Grace to forgive. Let the Lord give it to you tonight. I want you to pray that where you are weak, the grace of God will make you strong. Father, grace, 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 God's grace, grace that is greater than all our needs, grace, grace, God's grace. Father, give us grace, give us great grace, give us grace, give us great grace tonight, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Can we move on? Can we pray another prayer that everyone around you will see the work of grace in your life from now on? People will see you and they will wonder, how did you do it? And you will say, it's the grace of God, oh. Father, let people begin to see the walk of grace and the workings of grace in my life in the name of Jesus. All the people that are saying that I'm going to run out of grace, I'm going to run out of grace, surprise them by making them to begin to see the workings of grace in my life. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord tonight that the Lord will begin to walk the walk of grace in your life in the name of Jesus. That people that look upon you will see the grace of God at work. Father, let people that look upon me see the grace of God at work in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Can we pray another prayer tonight that all the deficiencies in your life, can I ask you to pray it, that Father, let all the deficiencies in my life, let your grace turn them into efficiencies in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Papa, all the deficiencies in my life, turn them into efficiencies in the name of Jesus. That may not be good English, but I know you understand what I'm saying. Everywhere that I'm deficient, let me become efficient by your grace. Let your grace make me efficient where I am deficient. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, there is nothing the grace of God cannot make out of a man. He made a Paul out of a Saul. I want you to pray tonight what I need to be, who I need to be. Let your grace make me to be in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. One of these days we are going to pray about our prayer lives. I want you to pray tonight. Say, Lord, let the grace of God change my prayer life tonight. Let the grace of God turn me into a man of prayer. Turn me into a woman of prayer. Let your grace, oh God, make prayer easy for me, oh God. Let my prayer life not be up and down. Let my prayer not be dead and alive. Let your grace make my prayer life to be strong and dynamic. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I hope you're praying where you are tonight, that all the deficiencies in your life, the grace of God will turn them into efficiencies. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that every lack, especially spiritual lack that may be in your life, the grace of God will supply. Hallelujah. The grace of God will supply. Hallelujah. Paul the Apostle said, I am what I am. Did you hear what I said? I am what I am by the grace of God. I want you to pray tonight. Oh God, let me be what you want me to be. Let your grace make me to be what you want me to be. Let your grace make me to be what you want me to be. Let your grace make me be what you want me to be. There are many of us that have desires. There are many of us that have aspirations. But it looks like we lack the strength. It looks like we lack the power. The grace of God can make you be who you are not. I want you to pray, go God, let your grace supply the lack of strength. Let your grace supply the lack of power. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight, everything you lack. You students who are among us, there's no reason why you should fail your papers. There's no reason why you should fail your course. The grace of God can make you a success. I want you to pray that where I lack talent, where I lack intelligence, where I lack understanding, grace of God, make it up for me. Grace of God, make it up for me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to decree tonight that for the rest of my life, daily grace, daily grace. Are you ready? Daily grace. Oh Lord, release it to us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, release daily grace to me, oh God. Father, release daily grace to me, oh God. Every day of my life. Father, release daily grace into my life every day in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, release daily grace. Are you praying for daily grace? That every area of your life, every day will be a day of grace. If somebody asks you, say, how are you doing? Well, I'm operating under grace today. If somebody walks to you and say, how are you doing today? Well, I tell you, I'm operating under the grace of God. I want you to pray tonight that every day that the day breaks, new grace for new day, new grace for new day shall be your portion in the name of Jesus. New grace to do your duties, new grace to do what you are doing, new grace to do what you need to do. It will be given unto you by fire. It will be given unto you by fire in the name of Jesus. New grace, Lord, release new grace upon our lives every day. Oh Lord, let it be a day of new grace for us in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Grace, oh God, mighty grace. Let it not depend on what I can do. Let it not depend on what I know. Let it not depend on what I have. Let it depend only on grace. Oh God of grace, let me experience your grace in my life in the name of Jesus, that I will look at myself and I will say, is this me? And people will look at me and say, is this you? I will say, it's not me, oh God. It's no longer I. That's what Paul said. He said, it's not I, it's the grace of God. I am what I am by the grace of God. That's what Paul the Apostle said. You know, sometimes we look at the people in the Bible, we look at Paul, we look at Peter, we look at all these great giants of God, and we say, wow, I wish I can be like them. Can I tell you something? You can be like them. You can even be better than them. If grace grace comes upon your life, say, Lord, let me collide with grace tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, remove my garment and give me the garment of grace. In the name of Jesus, cover me from my head to my toes with the grace of God Almighty abundant upon my life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' mighty, mighty, mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. I want us to pray some humble prayers. Oh, the next three prayers are prayers of humility. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, deliver me from depending on what I can do to protect myself. I repeat it. Say, my Father, deliver me, oh, from depending on what I can do to protect myself. Help me to depend on your gracious protection. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and fire prayer. In the name of Jesus, some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but I'm depending on your gracious protection. I wanted to tell the Lord, help me tonight not to depend on what I can do to protect myself. Of course, I would protect myself as is recommended, but my dependence will not be on that. My dependence will be on the gracious protection of God Almighty. I wanted to pray tonight, deliver me from depending on what I'm doing, from depending on what I can do to protect myself. Help me to depend on your gracious protection. Open your mouth and pray. Gracious protection. Gracious protection. Gracious protection. You know what gracious protection means? That's protection that you don't deserve. Protection that you don't deserve. Protection that you don't work for. And God gives it to you. Father, gracious protection. Give it to me. Give it to my husband. Give it to my wife, give it to my children, give it to my co-workers, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Gracious protection from heaven, gracious protection from God. Father, release it to us tonight, release it to us tonight, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for the answer, God. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We continue with our prayer of humility tonight. Prayer of humility. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, don't protect me, based on merit. If God is to protect you based on merit, you will have no protection. Because many of us don't merit anything. Say, Lord, don't protect me based on merit. But protect me from this virus based on your grace. Open your mouth and plead with God tonight. Father, don't protect me based on merit. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. If you protect me based on merit, I will fail. If you protect me based on merit, I will flunk it. But protect me, O Lord, based on grace. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Protect me based on grace. Don't protect me based on my prayerfulness. Don't protect me based on my holiness. Don't protect me based on my righteousness. Protect me because of your grace. Protect me because of your grace. Protect me because of your grace. Protect me because of your mercy. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, don't protect me based on merit. Protect me based on your grace from this wicked virus. Let your grace protect me in the name of Jesus. We pray for those of you who walk in the hospital. It will not be because you've been walking there for 20 years. Those who have walked for 25 years, they are dead and gone. That it will be the grace of God that keeps you. It's not because you are smart. You know how to treat patients. You know how to take care of patients. This thing is not by might. Oh, this thing is not by power. Oh, this thing is by the grace of God. Father, it's not by merit. It's by grace I'm asking for tonight. It's not by understanding. It's by grace I'm asking for tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. Hey. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's pray two more prayers of humility. The next one I want to pray is this. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, let me never look forward to what I deserve. Open your mouth and pray. Let me never look forward to what I deserve. but to what your kindness and your grace can do for me. Father, I'm looking forward tonight. Open your mouth and pray, not to what I deserve, but to what your grace can do for me, oh God. If I'm to get what I deserve, only God knows what will happen to me. But Lord, I'm not looking forward to what I deserve. I'm looking forward to what your grace can deliver. Oh God, not what I deserve, but what your grace can deliver. Not what I deserve, but what your grace can deliver. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, I come before you on this Thursday night. I'm looking forward not to what I deserve, but what your kindness, what your grace can do for me, can deliver for me. Oh God, whatever your grace delivers is good. Whatever your grace is delivered is uplifting. Whatever your grace delivers is proper. I want you to pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight, that you will never, 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 never look forward to what I deserve, but what the kindness of God, what the mercy of God can do for me. You know, I feel like going on my knees and praying tonight, but I cannot go on my knees. I have to keep standing in the name of Jesus. So I'm walking around this bedroom here, and I'm talking to God, and I'm saying, God, don't give me what I deserve. Give me what your grace can deliver. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, let your grace deliver healing. Let your grace deliver health. Let your grace deliver protection. The Lord be gracious to you, my brother who is praying that prayer. The Lord be gracious to you, my sister who is praying that prayer. May the Lord show you kindness. May the Lord show you mercy that you don't deserve. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. And amen. Let's pray another prayer of humility. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, my Father, my Father, my Father. Say, as your grace saved me from sin, let it always save me from every evil work, especially this virus. As your grace save me from sin, let it always save me from every evil work, especially coronavirus. Open your mouth and pray that prayer in the name of Jesus. The same grace that saved me from sin, oh God, let it save me from this coronavirus. The same grace that saved me from sin, Papa, let it save me from this coronavirus tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. It's by grace, oh. It's not by works. So I thank God for the works that we have to do. You know, you have to wash your hand. You have to cover your nose. You have to cover your mouth. You have to do six feet distancing. But look. Works alone will not do this thing. That's what the world will not tell you. You will not hear that on the news. You will not hear that on the television. You will not read that in print. But we know that it's not works alone. It's grace also. I want you to decree tonight, the grace that saved you from sin will always save you from every evil work, especially coronavirus. Say, my Father, my Father, my Father, the grace that saved me from sin, let it always save me from every evil work, especially coronavirus. In Jesus' name we pray. I love this prayer tonight, folks. Grace is good, oh. Grace is good. Grace is good. In the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight. Say, Father. Say, Father. Say, grace to live a healthy, virus-free life. Release it to me right now. Grace to live a healthy, virus-free life. Say, Papa, release it to me by fire. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, grace to live a healthy, virus-free life. Father, release it to me, release it to me, release it to me, release it to me tonight. If you want to stretch out your hand, you can stretch it out. But I want you to tell the Lord, the grace to live a healthy, virus-free life. Loose it to me right now. Papa, loose it to me right now. Grace, grace, grace to live a healthy, virus-free life. life. Father, release it to me tonight in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Grace to live a virus-free life, coronavirus-free life. Father, release that grace to us, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, release your grace to us, O God, that will help us to live a healthy, virus-free life. Father, loose it to people, O God, that are praying all across this nation, that are praying all across this world, in the name of Jesus, that will be hearing good news about one another, that will never hear that anyone on this prayer line fell down and died, that the coronavirus killed them. Lord, we cancel that in the name of Jesus. Grace, let it be upon this prayer line tonight. Grace, let it be upon this prayer line tonight. And those that will listen on podcast tomorrow, let grace be upon them to live a healthy, virus-free life, sickness-free life. Release that grace, Papa. Release that grace. Release that grace, Papa. Release that grace. Release that grace, Papa. Release that grace. In the name of Jesus, release that grace. In the name of Jesus, Papa, release that grace. In the name of Jesus, release that grace. And where there is sickness right now, where there is infection right now, let your grace flush them out. In the name of Jesus, let your grace kill them. Let your grace destroy them. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray, I want you to pray, I want you to pray that where there is sickness right now, where there is infection right now, the grace of God, the grace of God, the grace of God will flush out any unknown infection from your body, any unknown infection from your life, any unknown infection from your lungs, any unknown infection from any part of your body. The grace of God, the grace of God, the grace of God will release perfect health to every area of your life. Open your mouth and pray that prayer, that the grace of God will flush out every sickness. The grace of God will flush in perfect health. The grace of God, let it flush out any sickness, any affliction. Let it release perfect health to every area of my life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, let your grace release perfect health into every area of my life, into every area of my body, into every area of my children, into every area of the body of my husband, into every area of the body of my wife, into every area of the body of my parents. Lord, release it. Lord, release it. Lord, release it. In the name of Jesus, 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 in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. Let's make some commandment tonight. Say my health. Say my health. Say my health. Say begin to operate under an abundance of grace from now on in the name of Jesus. Say my health, my health, my health. I command you to begin to operate under an abundance of grace from now on in the name of Jesus. People, it's grace. Oh, it's not vitamin. It's not vitamin. That one is works. It's grace. Oh, it's not exercise. That one is works. Exercise is good. Vitamin is good. But grace is better. I want you to pray tonight in the name of Jesus. My health. I command you to begin to operate under an abundance of grace from now on in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. When your health is operating under an abundance of grace, what afflicts other people will not afflict you. What kills other people will not kill you. My health, in the name of Jesus, I speak to you that you begin to operate under an abundance of grace from now on. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, my health, from the top of my head to the soles of my feet, begin to operate under an abundance of grace right now in the name of Jesus. Begin to operate under an abundance of grace in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Bring all the organs in your body before God, that every organ in your body will begin to operate under an abundance of grace, of good health in the name of Jesus. My health, the health of my heart, the health of my kidneys, the health of my pancreas, the health of my brain, the health of my eyes, begin to operate under an abundance of grace from now on in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We got two more minutes. Can you believe this? We got two more minutes. We are operating under grace right now. We got two more minutes in the name of Jesus. Say, my Father, my Father, my Father. Come on, say, my Father, my Father, my Father. Let your grace put sufficient immunity into my body in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that the grace of God will inject you with sufficient immunity against coronavirus and every other sickness for that matter in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, let your grace, oh God, inject sufficient immunity. Let your grace work on my immune system and make it stronger than it ever was in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let your grace inject it. Let your grace pump grace in. Let your grace pump strength in into my immune system right now. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, grace of God. Inject sufficient immunity into my body to fight any sickness, to fight any virus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that the grace of God will inject protection so you will not become a victim of this viral infection, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. We got one more minute to go tonight. What prayer should I give you for the last one, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus? I want you to pray for the last prayer tonight, that as you go up and down, the grace of God will keep you from being a victim of the unexpected. Did you hear what I said? That the grace of God, as you go up and down, Lord God Almighty, let your grace keep me from being a victim of the unexpected. That's a prayer that covers everything. Oh, it covers accident, it covers everything, it covers infection, it covers everything. Say, my Father, as I go off this prayer line tonight, in the name of Jesus, and as I go up and down in life, let your grace keep me from being a victim of the unexpected. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, let your grace keep me from being a victim of the unexpected. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Have you ever heard this? Say, somebody died unexpectedly. Somebody collapsed unexpectedly. Unexpected wickedness, unexpected evil, grace of God, prevent it from my life. Grace of God, keep it from my life, I pray, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. The mission for tonight is fulfilled. Let's begin to praise God. The mission for tonight is ended. Let's begin to give God the praise for helping us tonight, for his grace that has been poured out upon our lives, for his keeping power that has been poured out upon our lives, for his countenance that is shining upon us right now. Father, we bless you. Father, we praise you. Father, we glorify you for new grace, for new strength, for new power that we receive right now. In Jesus' mighty, 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 mighty name we pray. And everybody said amen. Everybody said amen. Let me pray for you. Father, we just thank you. Hallelujah. We bless you. Father, we worship you because we have prayed in the name of Jesus. And Lord, you remember you said, whatsoever we ask the Father in your name, you will give it to us. We have asked for keeping grace tonight. And we believe that is upon us abundantly. We have asked that you will shine upon us. And we believe we are operating under your favor tonight. Favor from God and favor from man. And we have asked you that you be gracious to us tonight. You said, if we ask, we shall receive. If we seek, we shall find. If we knock, the door shall be opened unto us. We believe that the victory is won tonight. We believe that a new day has dawned upon our lives. We believe that new blessings have come upon our lives. And we receive them in the name of the Father. We receive them in the name of the Son. We receive them in the name of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And all God's people everywhere across the world said amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you so much for joining us tonight for this prayer. We bless the name of the Lord for it. Don't forget tomorrow night. Hey! We're going to close tomorrow night with peace, 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 peace. Peace that passes all understanding. You will not believe how many people are depressed during this pandemic, young and old, rich and poor. Everybody is tired. Everybody is, and you can begin to see the violence. People violently reacting because they are not happy. The joy of the Lord is our strength. So we're going to pray tonight, tomorrow night, that every spirit of heaviness will depart from us as we join it. I don't know how we'll do it, but I'll see how to do it. I will join it with Ecclesiastes chapter 10 that we talked about last week, that you will have peace concerning coronavirus. You will have peace concerning every area of your life. And for the rest of your life, every agent that is contrary to peace, the Lord will separate you from them so you can have the peace of God. That is a prophetic word for somebody. I pray that the Lord will bless you as you go tonight. But please don't forget, go online, www.freshanointing.org. Support this ministry. Support this church by giving online. www.freshanointing.org/giveonline. You follow the steps and it will be done and the blessing shall be yours in the name of Jesus. Shall we share the grace together in fellowship right now? 1, 2, let's go. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen and amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen, amen, and amen. Until tomorrow, when we come your way again to pray shalom for the peace of God, may God keep you safe. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Good night.